This is infotainment. Ukamva sasikulira choncho umaziwa kuti nkhani za msangulusu zabwera. Tikuwuzeni kuti kunali chani nkhani za msangulusu komanso kukhalinso chani nkhani za msangulusu. Dzina langa ndi Sam Banda Jr. And in this edition we speak to soldier Lucius Banda, who tells us more about his 20th album titled Love and Hurt. He basically announced that this would probably be his last album. But is he quitting music? That's what you are going to find out in this edition of Infotainment. Again, we also look at a premiere of a movie titled Neria's Dream by Bright Africa Makina. It premiered in Blantyre at Golden Peacock. We've got a lot more to tell you on that. And we also look at Voice Africa, connected by Airtel. Basically, it's here and it's a singing competition where they're calling on singers, they're calling on those who know that they've got good voices to come out, send their videos and stand a chance of participating in this Voice Africa contest, which will draw contestants from 14 countries, as well as select 7 participants from each country, including Malawi. All you can do is stay right there as I bring you more in Infotainment, a basket full of arts and entertainment. But remember, this program comes to you courtesy of UNICAF.
UNICAF University celebrates the success of 154 graduates from 44 different countries who have earned their bachelor, master, and doctoral degrees in 2022.
My doctoral thesis have given me a valuable exposure to modern day practices across the world. It has enhanced my self-confidence and changed me as a person on many different levels.
Being able to complete my MBA degree online, enjoying the flexibility of studying anywhere and at any time that was convenient, enabled me to fit my studies around my busy schedules as a medical doctor.
Studying online for my BSc in computer science degree allowed me the freedom to do my research and light my assignments whenever and wherever I wanted.
Join us today and start building the career of your dreams.
Now we start our program with a story about soldier Lucius Banda. He's been in the music industry for more than 30 years and he's been producing one album after the other. And now he's about to release his 20th album titled Love and Hate. He says probably this will be his last album. This album, Love and Hate, has got 20 songs and it is his 20th album. So we caught up with him recently when he was in Blantyre performing at one of the events. And we caught up with him just to share more details about Love and Hate. What is it all about? And is he quitting music? As he did announce recently that this would probably be his last album. Is he quitting music? Let's hear from soldier Lucius Banda.
Love and Hate, it's I think a lot of people have been asking what kind of stuff we are bringing to the table. Love and Hate, as the title is, it's my experiences of how one who's a friend today may become the worst enemy the following day, and vice versa. The main theme of this album is that one. We are looking at how people betray each other, how people don't understand each other, and issues like those. That's what is being highlighted in this album. It's an album with 20 songs. Everyone gets surprised, how come that you have 20 songs in an album? that this is music that I've been composing and writing. Some of them have been released, and I'll keep releasing. Maybe before we release the album, three more tracks will be released. As you might have seen, Ibiza Ibiza has been released and people have received so well. So there'll be more songs because it's a 5-year project. To be honest, in terms of albums, I might be stopping here. Once in a while, if I feel like I may come up with a single, possibilities of them being gospel songs are high because, I mean, it has been my dream that after age 50, I save God. But I'll not be as busy as I have been. And like I was saying on stage, not releasing albums may also mean fewer shows that will be done by me, basically, because, you know, the body is tired. I am 52, but I feel 80, 90 because of how much I've overworked myself. So I feel the remaining of the time, apart from doing music partially, I should also focus on my family and all that. No, I can't say it's quitting for good. Music is a lifestyle. It's not very easy for a person to say I'm quitting music. Music is something that you don't quit. You quit music when you die. But I think I will be working in, I think like a professional artist who is not on the street every weekend. There will be like those shows that artists that are established to do. This is the model that we've been using in Malawi, is the one which we perform every weekend. For example, today we're here, tomorrow we're at Brandy Sports Club. Those are things which will not be happening anymore. To boost up my band, once in a while I'll travel with them, but most of the time they'll be going alone. I will be home. Mind you, I have to manage the situation of my brothers who are not well. And I'm also not 100% well. I have to go for dialysis twice a week. So it's been too much for my health.
Yeah, that's so Jalusius Banda there, talking more about his 20th album, Love and Hate. And he clearly said that he's not quitting music, but then he will narrow down, especially in terms of his performances, how he was doing in the past. Remember, you're watching Infotainment, a basket full of arts and entertainment, and my name is Sam Banda Jr. Now, from So Jalusius Banda, we move on to Voice Africa. Voice Africa, connected by Airtel, has launched the Malawi edition, and it was launched on Tuesday. That's at Sandbelt Mount Sochi in Blantyre, and this is a competition, a singing competition that is inviting those who know that their vocal abilities are that good in terms of singing. Should send their 1-minute videos. 1-minute video, actually, I should say that. 1-minute video to a website which is www.thevoice.africa, where they will send their videos. And after that, those videos will be processed. Those who will receive a message to say they've gone through, they'll be invited for a live audition. And from that live audition, they will then select 7 participants from each country, and there are 14 countries, and there will be one winner. So after the 7 have been selected, the 7 will be selected automatically. They will be given $5,000, and then they will proceed to Nigeria, and that's for a training where they'll go through a training, and then after that the competition will start in March. And then in September, that's when the winner will be crowned, and the winner will walk away with $100,000. So everyone is eligible to participate as long as they enter using an Airtel line. So we're there as Infotainment when they're launching the Malawi edition, and we spoke to that's the PR manager, that's Nora Nora Chavula Chirwa, who tells us more about Voice Africa, as well as we spoke to Essie James or Essie X, one of the artists, sharing her comment basically on the whole competition. And there were performances which were spice up the whole launch, and a performance from Kevin Sings, and there was also a karaoke session. So we'll see the highlights of what happened during the launch. Let's take a look. That's Kelvin Sings there, spicing up the Voice Africa Malawi edition launch, which took place at Sunbelt Mount Sochi in Blanda. That's on Tuesday. And you heard from Nola Chavula Chirwa, that's the PR and CSR manager at Airtel Malawi. And you also heard from Essie James or SX, one of the artists. Popularly known for her song, actually titled China Love. Now, moving out of there, we still sticking on to music, and this name is not new, actually, on the music landscape. His name is Onesimus. Recently, he won an award for Best Artist Southern Africa, which was very good, and he's had a number of songs that have won the hearts of people. And recently, he has also dropped a new music video titled Sugar. And then he also spoke about his latest album, which he is about to release. So we caught up with him just to share more details about the new music video, Sugar, as well as how it fit to grab an award, Best Artist Southern Africa, that's in the Zikom Awards in Zambia. And again, also just to tell us, who is he basically? Is he a gospel musician? Is he just a musician? Because he's been in the gospel music sphere, but what he's been doing recently, others have started saying no, maybe he's moved out of gospel. Let's hear from Onesmus.
Took us about 6 months to shoot the music video. Everything you saw on set is built. Everything, we had to weld things from the scratch. Everything had to be done from the scratch. It took us 6 months to build the set and about 2 months to shoot the music video. The video, the concept is about me protecting my woman. This is my yard, she's my queen. Anyone who tries to enter, definitely you're going down. I'm a musician, I have to compose. Whether I'm in love, I'm not in love, whether I'm heartbroken or not, it doesn't matter whether I've won something or not, but I have to make music for each and every person at all seasons to make sure that everybody's enjoying the music. You know, the album kind of delayed a bit. I'm yet to make a public statement. Maybe this is one of the public statements that I've been making regarding the album release. The album release is going to take another 2 months, so we're going into February next year. We've just shifted the dates to February next year. Month end of February, the album will be coming out. Which Malawians should be looking forward to the album. People should look forward to more music and more music. That's me. I'm just a musician. I do gospel, I do love songs, I do any other songs. So it doesn't matter what genre I'm doing, but I do music. So people shouldn't be worried about it because I'm a child of God and I'm allowed to make any music. I love Malawi. I just want to thank them for supporting me always. There's no Onesmus without Malawi. Citizen of this country, and I'm proud to be so, and thank you for supporting me. I couldn't have achieved what I've achieved if I was not born in my life. Thank you. Sugar, sugar, baby.
Baby, oh baby. That is mine, don't touch, I beg you. Somebody, don't test me, I beg you. Baby, baby, yeah. I'll go mad for your love, I swear, I swear. I will kill somebody, baby, don't play. I'll go crazy for this love, I swear.
Yeah, that's Onesmus there, sharing more on his latest music video, that's titled Sugar, as well as sharing more details on the album that is about to launch. Remember, you're watching Infotainment, a basket for arts and entertainment, and my name is Sam Banda Jr. And remember also that this program comes to you courtesy of UNICAF.
UNICAF University celebrates the success of 154 graduates from 44 different countries who have earned their bachelor, master, and doctoral degrees in 2022.
My doctoral thesis have given me a valuable exposure to modern-day practices across the world. It has enhanced my self-confidence and changed me as a person on many different levels.
Being able to complete my MBA degree online, enjoying the flexibility of studying anywhere and at any time that was convenient, enabled me to fit my studies around my busy schedules as a medical doctor.
Studying online for my BSc in computer science degree allowed me the freedom to do my research and light my assignments whenever and wherever I wanted.
Join us today and start building the career of your dreams.
We are back, and continuing with our program, Infotainment, a basket for arts and entertainment. Now, a new movie premiered at Golden Peacock in Blantyre, this movie has been produced by Bright Africa Makina. A lot of people attended the premiere of the movie, and it basically tackles the issue of early marriages. It's a short movie, but the film actually impressed a number of people who patronized the premiere, and one of them is veteran filmmaker Shemu Joya. And after the premiere itself, we had an interview with Shemu Joya, as well as the producer of the movie, that's Bright Africa Makina. Let's see what happened. And there was also actually a performance from Mjangu Comedies that spice up the whole premiere. Let's see the highlights from the premiere.
When I grow up, I want to be a train driver.
Is this how your mom taught you how to cook?
I'm nervous, excited, afraid in the film, because I didn't expect the audience the way they have come out. So I'm overwhelmed, I can say that. I'm a social worker, so whenever I'm listening to news, reading papers, hearing about number of girls dropping out of school, that's what motivated me to write a film about it and tour it across Malawi in schools and community to teach girls that despite being pregnant, being married early, but they can still go back to school, they still have the time that they can make things right. The next thing is to premiere it in Lilongwe. When we're done in Lilongwe, go to Zuzu, but I said in Blantyre, so now the plan is to tour schools around Blantyre, and maybe Mlanje, Cholo, Chihuahua, then go to Lilongwe. And Lilongwe, when I premiered, also visit schools across Lilongwe, and some districts in central region, and something in northern region. Nelia.
When I grow up, I want to be a train driver.
Is this how your mom taught you how to cook?
No, I loved the film so much. First of all, the story, it was nicely flowing from. Because one of the biggest challenges I've seen with Malawian films is that we don't have a consistent story that flows nicely from one scene to another. With this one, you could clearly see how the film is moving, and I really commend the writer, Bright, those films, so that it's one way of giving the companies advertising space, but at the same time, the companies are helping the productions to go on. So I was very, very impressed that Bright tried his best to at least get a company into this movie. I really loved the film. As I say, during the question and answer time, the story is brilliant. It's exactly what happens.
Oh! Hey. Hey.
Yeah, that's the premiere of a film titled Nelia's Dream at Golden Peacock in Blantyre. Now, moving out of there, we go on to theater. The Malawi International Theater Festival is set to be inaugurated. That's in December, starting on December 1st up to December 4th. And the organizers basically organized a press conference that's at Amaris Hotel in Blantyre. So we had an interview with Bright Chaya Chaya, who is the lead coordinator, as well as National Theatre Association of Malawi, NTAM president, that's Maxo Chipinga, popularly known as Max DC. Let's hear from the two.
My name is Bright Chaya Chaya, the lead coordinator for the Malawi International Theatre Festival. So basically the festival is all about celebrating theatre in Malawi, celebrating culture in Malawi. So what we're trying to do is to bring together several theatre companies, both from Malawi and international theatre groups that will come and give us a theatre experience so that we explore and look at issues that are affecting Malawi as well as the region in Africa, and as well as share culture to both the audiences and the performances. So what we're trying to do basically is to give a theatre experience to the local and international audiences in Malawi. We have the first day, we have the launch of the festival, which so happens to be the World AIDS Day. So we have dedicated that day to explore the issues of HIV and AIDS in Malawi as well as in the whole world. And then the following days, like Friday and Saturday, we also have the festival is coming during the 16 days of activism, so we also look at issues of gender-based violence, and we have planned for free shows that will be performed in markets that will basically raise awareness on issues of gender-based violence. So, and then the final day is the awards gala as well, so whereby we'll be awarding people that have done exceptionally well in people and groups that have done exceptionally well in theatre in Malawi.
My name is Maxwell Denson Chipinga, in the entertainment circles known as Max DC. I am the president of National Theatre Association and the director of Emancipation Theatrical Ensemble. What makes this festival unique is the fact that it is being spearheaded by the theatre body, National Theatre Association. So it is a national thing because National Theatre Association has got so many members within it. Even so, Monique Peacocks is a member of National Theatre Association. So you can see now that this is now becoming to be something which is an overall thing. It is coming to incorporate all aspects of the theatre industry. And again, it is bringing in international artists, international acts to come also in Malawi. This festival, we have about 8 international groups that are coming, one from the USA. So I think it's going to be one of the first to host a number of international artists to that level, like, you know, 8 groups, and also 12 groups from local, bringing them together to exchange their theatre experiences and performances. That's what makes this unique. And again, what makes it unique from other festivals is that it is a theatre-based festival. Most of them are, the ones that we have are more musical, you know, are bands and all, but here we are having theatre. So we have an audience out there that loves theatre. Probably they want to watch anything that has to do with theatre. They want to experience probably even the international theatre companies.
On that note, we've come to the very end of Infotainment, a basket for arts and entertainment. My name is Sam Banda Jr. I hope you've enjoyed what I brought on to you in this edition of Infotainment. Remember, Miss Malawi has released a short list of the top 12, and basically they will remove 2 and remain with 10 ahead of the main event coming up in December. We'll give you more on that, and just to give you some highlights on we'll give you some highlights in our next edition on Tumaini Festival, Hangout Festival, as well as Focus on Ability Film Festival. As I said, my name is Sam Banda Jr. Keep it times as well as Infotainment. Ciao.